So cyber threats evolve daily, making your device vulnerable to malware, phishing scams, and hacking attacks. So in this digital landscape, is Windows Defender good enough to keep up with the spread of malware? In this Windows Antivirus Review 2025, I'm going to examine everything it can do for me and what it can't. So let's start with a simple question. What is Windows Defender? So don't look at me like that. I don't think you're stupid. I think Windows is. It's simply confusing since between Microsoft Security, Windows Security, and Windows Defender, only the last one is the antivirus app we gathered to discuss. The other two are paid extensions with additional security elements, which I will not cover today because basic security upgrades for a $140 OS are cringe. Anyways, Windows Defender is the built-in antivirus solution that comes with Windows 10 and 11, at least until Windows 10 gets discontinued later in 2025. So yeah, if you came looking for the best antivirus for Windows 10, you'll be forced to switch pretty soon. So Windows Defender works entirely automatically in the background of your system. What exactly does it do? Well, Windows Defender comes with a rather standard antivirus functionality, malware protection. It's pretty self-explanatory. It offers a set of different scanning options from quick to full, and of course, some customization if you only need specific apps scanned. I'm gonna test its performance later in the video, so keep your eyes peeled. Now, firewall and network protection are also basic features that any best antivirus for Windows 11 should have. I can keep the firewall up or disable it, whitelist certain apps, and even set custom rules. Now, keep in mind though, that this feature has barely changed since the days of Windows XP. So it's hardly an inspiring thought. Now, Windows Defender is not done yet, okay? It also provides account protection, primarily for Microsoft accounts. PIN, fingerprint, and face recognition authentication methods are the most often used option. But complicated authentication does not help much by itself, and Windows Defender doesn't monitor password security or breaches. That said, app and browser control comes close to that by monitoring my activity for signs of suspicious websites, apps, files, or malware. It also scans everything I download from the web, but that's, of course, the bare minimum. Windows Defender can also send regular reports on system services, storage, and apps, practically ensuring that my PC is working properly and improving performance and stability. Now, of course, it also has some family-oriented benefits, such as parental controls, but all settings have to be managed through a Microsoft account, which adds to the hassle. Honestly, this is the most basic antivirus functionality. I mean, Windows Defender truly focuses on the bare minimum without offering any advanced or standout features. Most antiviruses these days come with better toolkits. If you'd like to hear more details about various antivirus VPN or password manager apps, make sure to leave a like and subscribe to the channel. I post in-depth app reviews regularly. As I've said, Windows Defender is really basic, but that shouldn't matter if it does a good job, right? Well, it does. I decided to drop 100 malware files in my system and then check how many Windows Defender will actually detect with a full scan. I've also repeated this process with TotalAV and Norton, two of the most popular independently audited antivirus apps. As you can see, Windows Defender does its job somehow, despite sometimes loading my CPU up to 100%, it did detect 61 malware files in around 30 minutes. But that's not such a good result. TotalAV caught 72 in total, no pun intended. However, it used more CPU and took longer to complete the task. Norton, however, both finished faster and with minimal CPU usage while detecting as many malware files as TotalAV. But these results didn't account for the real-time protection, which I had to disable to even plant the 100 malware files in the first place. With RTP enabled, I've tried planting 50 different malware files once again, only to have most of them caught immediately. Windows Defender grabbed 30 while TotalAV got rid of 41 and Norton got rid of 46. In total, it's clear that a standalone antivirus provider can and will provide better overall protection than Microsoft Defender. So if you want to get better security for your device, consider scanning this QR code or checking the link in the description to get the best deal for Norton or Total AV. Yeah, discounts are quite necessary if you're gonna upgrade from an essentially free Windows Defender. Now, Total AV and Norton are premium antivirus solutions. So, of course, they don't come cheap, or so you would think, right? Considering my deals, you will be able to get both at a considerably reduced cost. Besides, hey, this is not the price for just the antivirus with features similar to Microsoft Defender antivirus. For instance, Norton can cover up to 10 different devices, regardless of operating system, with advanced malware protection while including system optimization features, cloud backup, a VPN, password manager, and parental controls. Total AV can also cover multiple devices, up to 8 of them, while including a VPN and a password manager as well. The only downside is the lack of firewall, but this just means that Windows Defender's free firewall will work instead. And yeah, it's pretty decent. So besides, I consider both providers much more convenient to use than Windows Defender. Instead of a confusing, convoluted layout of the Windows security page, I get to use neatly designed, optimized apps with detailed feature explanations for beginners. So look, I'd like to describe more, but there is a limit on how much time I have. So if you're curious, just consider checking out my full reviews for Norton and Total AV. In short, Windows Defender is not bad, but it's also certainly not enough. The best antivirus 2025 needs more than a subpar scan. And to get the most comprehensive malware, phishing, and password protection, you gotta have an all-encompassing solution like Norton or Total AV. So you can learn more about those providers and how to get the best deal through the links in the description. Thanks for watching this far. I hope you enjoyed the video. Let me know if you have any questions, and I hope to see you in the next one. Bye.